हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ अमृता श्रीवास्तव एंड आई एम अ फैकल्टी ऑफ यूएस अकेडमी इंस्टीट्यूट गोरखपुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास सिक्स मॉरल साइंस चैप्टर सिक्स एंड द टाइटल इज द रिमोर्स ऑफ अ मॉन्क। स्टूडेंट्स, द मीनिंग ऑफ रिमोर्स इज इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग व्हेन यू हैव डन समथिंग रॉन्ग। सो अ फीलिंग ऑफ सैडनेस बिकॉज यू हैव डन समथिंग wrong. So this chapter is about a monk, a saint who was very sad just because he had done something wrong. This chapter is about regret and sadness due to done something wrong. So let's read and start our chapter. Li Wong was the head of Buddhist monastery in Tibet that housed a large and rich collection of books and was famous for it. So students, Li Wong was the head of Buddhist monastery, means it's a kind of convent in Tibet, and that house was famous for a large and rich collection of books. The collections had a few books that were very rare, hence very precious. And there lots of very precious and rare books was kept. One fine day, a visiting monk who was also a scholar happened to spot a volume of rare book and falling prey to temptation took and book, packed it with his belongings and left the monastery. The theft was discovered the same day. So one fine day, a monk was there for visit and he was also a scholar, and suddenly he got a volume of some rare books and it was falling victim that he just got temptation of the book of gaining, and he just took all the collection of books and left from the convent, and at the same day the theft was discovered. Li Wong did not have any difficulty in guessing who the thief was, but he did not send anyone after the visiting monk. If the monk denied, he will add the sin of telling lies to that of the theft. Li Wong was knowing that the monk was thief, but he did not send anyone to ask him, just because if the monk will tell lie that he had not taken the books, the sin of telling lies will be added on the life of the thief. The monk came to the town and tried to sell off the books to make a fortune. He found a buyer who asked him to leave the rare book with him for evaluation. The monk agreed and left the book. So the next time the thief monk went to a town and he just tried to sell off the books to gain a profit. He found a buyer who asked him to leave the books for evaluation, and monk just left the books to the buyer. The buyer, a rich merchant, took the book to Li Wong. A monk wants to sell this book and is asking for 10 gold coins. You are a renowned scholar. Tell me, is it worth the price? So the buyer explained to Li that one saint was there to sell these books and he was asking for 10 gold coins. Please guide me if the book is worth that amount or not. The merchant asked Li Wang. Li Wang recognized the book but did not show his feeling. When Li Wang saw the books, he just knew that the same book from his library. He said it is worth 100 coin, maybe more. It is a rare book. And he said to the buyer that the book is worth more than 100 gold coins just because it is rare and precious book. The merchant thanked Li Wang and left. He called the monk the next day and said, I will buy your books for 10 gold coins. So next day he informed to the monk that I can buy your books and I will give you 10 gold coins. He felt delighted. He asked, from whom did you get it evaluated? The merchant replied, I sold it to Li Wang. The monk turned pale. What else did he tell you? He asked. Nothing, replied the merchant. The monk felt very sorry for his deed. He realized that Li Wang has refused to recognize the stolen book so that the thief would not get in trouble. He had never seen such greatness before. So when the buyer informed him about 10 gold coins, the monk asked, how did you evaluate the price of the book? And the merchant replied, by Li Wang. Suddenly, the monk turned pale and he realized his big fault, his big mistake, that Li Wang is very great personality. He did not told the buyer this is a book from his library just to ensure that thief would not get in trouble. And that time that monk realized that he had never seen such great personality ever before. The monk took the book back from the merchant and said, I have changed my mind. I don't want to sell this book anymore. The merchant tried to lure him. I will offer you 20 gold coins. But the monk took the book and ran straight to the monastery to meet Li Wang. When the monk realized his big mistake, he refused to sell the book to the merchant and said that I have changed my mind. I will not sell these books. But merchant was knowing that books are worth more than 100 gold coins. So he offered 20 gold coins. But monk refused to sell the books. She just took the book and ran straight to meet Li Wang. So when he met with Li Wang said that I was knowing that you are so fond of the book, so I decided to give it to you. And that time monk felt very sorry. He was regretting at that time. So he requested, I will keep the books only if you allow me to stay here in the monastery for the rest of my life. And that time monk requested to Li Wang that please allow me to live here and to serve this monastery for rest of my life. Li Wang smiled and agreed, and the monk spent the rest of his life learning lessons of wisdom and morality from Li Wang. On that day, the monk decided to spend rest of his life in learning lessons of wisdom and morality from Li Wang. So students, you must understand that it is better to make someone realize her or his mistake than to punish or ridicule. If anyone is doing any mistake, so make them understand that it is wrong. Do not punish them. A great man is one who does not make other men feel small but makes other men feel great. So you could be a great man by not making other men feel small, just to make them feel great. So let's see what the questions are saying. Answer the following questions orally. Who was Li Wang? Li Wang was the head of the Buddhist monastery. What did the visiting monk do? Found some rare books, and he just kept these books with his belongings and left the place. Why did Li Wang not ask the monk about the theft? Just because he just wanted to monk realize his own mistake. When did the monk realize his mistake? When the monk knew that Li Wang was knowing about the books, but he did not tell it to the merchant, the monk realized his mistake. What did the monk decide to do at last? The monk decided to stay in the monastery for the rest of his life. Write true or false in the boxes given alongside. The monk got the book issued for reading. False. The monastery had a collection of rare books. True. The monk wanted to read the book. False. Merchant bought the book for 100 gold coins. False. The monk realized his mistake and apologized for it. True. One activity is given here that you have to do. Think about the non-course books that you have read in any language. So first question is given, write the title of your book that you like the most. And second, also write why you like this book more than the other books. Books are treated as treasure for those who enjoy getting the most from them. Ask your parents, grandparents to provide you some books beyond your course book, because reading, it is always says that reading makes a full man. So keep reading books. First, you should read from your syllabus, and second, you can read some books out of your syllabus. This is for your homework, student. What did you get from this story? Write a short paragraph. What do you understand by reading this story? And what is the gain of the day? The gain of the day is the error is human, to forgive divine. That means making mistake is human nature, and forgiving him is divine's nature. That means people are acting in a godlike way when they forgive others. If you are forgiving others, that means you are doing a divine like act. So students, that was all about your sixth chapter, the remorse of the monk, and we will discuss our next chapter in our next video. Till then, take care.